Welcome back to our live coverage of the BJP's Sankalp Patra, which will be released in the next few minutes. Rajnath Singh, Union Defence Minister, has reached the BJP headquarters. You can see Ashwini Vaishnav, the Railway Minister, welcoming him with a shawl, a BJP shawl. Of course, all eyes now on the BJP headquarters, where the Prime Minister is expected to reach in the next few minutes and release the BJP's Sankalp Patra, as you see Rajnath Singh making way to the main hall, where the Sankalp Patra will be released. He's, of course, welcomed there by both Ashwini Vaishnav and Tarun Chugh. Let me go across to our reporters. Arunima is also joining us. So there will be a straight-up comparison, Arunima, in a few moments once the BJP Sankalp Patra is released, between what the BJP is promising and what the Congress has promised in its Nyaya Patra a few days ago. Can you walk our viewers through why this could possibly be a study in contrast?
You know, if you see the Nyaya Patra and everything that the Congress party has been saying, their focus has been on first, sops for the economically deprived. They've promised money into the accounts of women specifically. They've also been talking about the caste census. Prime Minister, in contrast, says the caste is only divided in this country into four groups: youth, women, and those who are economically deprived, so subcategory in that. So there is a sharp contrast in the way the Congress and the Bharatiya Janata Party have been talking about sociological development for the country in the last 5 years. I've had a chance to tour Madhya Pradesh, which goes to elections in the first polls, the Chindwara area. I am coming to you live from Nagpur on a day like today, when B.R. Ambedkar is being celebrated. And you just told the viewers how the Prime Minister paid his homage. Nagpur is also buzzing. This is where the Deeksha Bhumi is. This is where Bhimrao Ambedkar, took over Buddhism as his religion. So this city is buzzing. Home Minister Amit Shah, who's there on the stage, is expected to be in Maharashtra shortly. He's also addressing a rally here, telling the people about the guarantee that is being promised in this Sankalp Patra. But other than the sociological impact of the Sankalp Patra, Zaka, I would also be looking out as to how the Bharatiya Janata Party, in its third term, if they come to power, are looking at the foreign policy and national security aspect. Prime Minister has made his ambition very clear. India must become a Vishwa Guru. We are looking at a world where the Russia-Ukraine war was still ongoing. There's a summit planned in Switzerland. And even before that was resolved, Israel and Gaza conflict began. And that this morning, there's a fresh crisis brewing in that. In all of this, what is it seeing for itself? What is it seeing for itself as far as national security goes? Home Minister Amit Shah will be there on the stage, and his contribution to national security cannot be underlined enough. So that's one section that I will be looking out for in the Sankalp Patra.
All right, Aman and Arun Danta are also there with us. Arun Danta, very quickly, just in terms of Modi ki guarantee, the Congress and the other opposition parties are also saying that we're also giving guarantees. And I was in Tamil Nadu last week, we'll be going to Karnataka this week. One of the guarantees that they're talking about in opposition-ruled states is the free bus rides and the minimum 1,000 or 1,500 rupees to women. So just walk us through why the BJP believes these are ravdis and these don't necessarily work, and why Modi ki guarantee trumps whatever other Nyaya guarantees the opposition is offering.
Well, see, Zaka, that's the point which opposition parties have been raising, that when we talk about giving free electricity, free water, and free rides, and so on and so forth, they call it, ravdi culture. On the other hand, when they talk about such things, why that is not called ravdi culture? But the response of the BJP in this regard is that, for them, what is important is the delivery. Even if they promise something, delivery is something which they are ensuring. And that is the reason why, Zaka, it has been ensured to the Manifesto Committee that whatever it will be, whatever they will be doing in that tra, it should be only that thing which can be achieved by Bharatiya Janata Party. And that has been, of course, the track record of...
All right, just give me a moment, Arun. I'm sorry to interrupt. You can see the Prime Minister just exiting his vehicle. The BJP president is there, defense minister is there, home minister is there. As you see, the BJP president welcoming the prime minister with a shawl and presenting him with a rose. Of course, the prime minister will be releasing the BJP's Sankalp Patra, its manifesto for the 2024 elections. As you see, the big four of the BJP, the prime minister, the home minister, the defense minister, and of course the BJP party president, Mr. Nadda, walking up the steps of the BJP national headquarters. The Prime Minister, of course, in a few moments from now, from the main hall, will be releasing the Sankalp Patra for 2024, which is the BJP's manifesto. Aman Sharma is also joining us. Aman, I remember before the 2019 election, the big ticket announcement in the manifesto was the Kisan Samman Nidhi for the 2024 manifesto.
Well, Zaka, we'll have to wait for the manifesto. You know, it's difficult to predict what the BJP may next do and promise because it's a very closely guarded secret, as we all know. But when it comes to the two major schemes, Zaka, the PM Kisan Nidhi and Ayushman Bharat. These two schemes were launched and of the 6,000 a year to about 10 crore farmers, and Ayushman Bharat, a 5 lakh insurance to, you know, as many families in the payout in this scheme should be increased. Maybe Ayushman Bharat should cover more of the middle class, for example, you know, to bring more people under its ambit. The free medical insurance scheme of rupees 5 lakh for a family, and PM Kisan Nidhi money, which is rupees 2,000 installment thrice a year, increased as well. Wait if the BJP, you know, actually offers this, because it has not done so in the past state elections also when there was a big demand about it. But I think after about the big promises, Zaka, if you look at which the BJP is projecting their major promises that they have fulfilled, the Modi ka guarantee which has been fulfilled, be it 100% outrified Ramodrayan 3, abrogation of Article 370, Pran Pratishthan of Bhagwan Shri Ram at Ayodhya, crore, they are saying, so you know, the roadmap to the third largest economy, what happens this time. If you see also these reservation for women, 33% reservation for women in parliament and state legislative assemblies, now this law has been passed in this term of the Modi government. What will be the roadmap to the implementation of the women's reservation law over the next 5 years? Will we see it in the 2029 Lok Sabha election? Is something that, you know, maybe the manifesto throws light upon. Also the point about, as I said earlier, one nation, one election, a major thing on the BJP's agenda, that for 2029 we see simultaneous Lok Sabha and state legislative assembly election. About use, what Uttarakhand has done, or does the BJP have a central national plan for UCC as well? That will be revealed in the, which the BJP has been strongly saying. You see this in this pamphlet also for the media which has been released, that we have, in BJP has ensured food security for 80 crore Indians. It is extended beyond the elections also now. And you know how this scheme has worked wonders the court. And will this all in the manifesto as a big achievement of the Modi government, which maybe is taken forward over the next 5 years? We'll have to wait to see what the manifesto exactly says about that.
All right. As you can see, Vinod Tavade, the BJP General Secretary there, welcoming the guests, the media persons and other party leaders of the BJP who have arrived there at the main hall. You saw him even at the BJP headquarters, first going to the statue of Baba Saheb Ambedkar, the Home Minister, the Defence Minister, the BJP Party President, making their way now to the main hall, where they will be releasing in the next few minutes the BJP Sankalp Patra, its 2024 manifesto. Payal is also joining us. Payal, obviously for the BJP, and they've made this absolutely clear through the campaign trail as well, they see fresh catchment areas, areas of growth for the BJP as a party in the south and in the east. Can we expect something to be explicitly mentioned about the south and the east in the manifesto?
Zaka, what you can see on your screen is, you can see Prime Minister Narendra Modi on the dais. He is, of course, accompanied by BJP's National President JP Nadda, BJP's former President Rajnath Singh, and of course, somebody who's heading the campaign committee. There's, of course, former President Amit Shah, one of the most successful presidents of the BJP in their tenure, and of course, Nirmala Sitharamanan, who's the co-convener as far as the manifesto committee is really concerned. So these are the people who are there on the dais, and they will in fact be, paying tributes to Baba Bhimrao Ambedkar. That's something which is going to happen on the dais. Camera. Right, so my cameraman is going to get you those visuals, and he's going to get you those shots that you're able to see right now. Right, so you know that's something which is happening on the dais, and you can see in the front row are seated several union ministers. You know, there's of course Hardeep Singh Puri, Anurag Singh Thakur, Jay Shankar, all of these ministers are seated on the dais right now. As we wait for expecting we are sitting here. So we can expect one of its kind to really come in, because this is the third.